going into all. Can you guess the title from the given picture?
Filters.
Yeah, the first picture shows filter. Then next one, picking. Yeah, picking. Then third one.
That is a car. The name is Isuzu.
Okay, car Isuzu is not a car. Isuzu down the side MUX MUX. So the multiplexer is used to select the filters. So filter selection using multiplexer. So these three pictures coming together, filter selection using multiplexer. So today's session, the title is filter selection using multiplexer. So why we have chosen the particular topic filter selection using multiplexer? In telecommunication, so this is earth station, transmitter, satellite, satellite dish, receiver. So while transferring the information from transmitter to receiver, a lot of noises is added to the signal. So the noises may be environmental noises or system level noises. So to remove the noises, a lot of filters are used. Based on the applications, we have to select any one filter is done by multiplexer. So here using 2:1 multiplexer. So the 2 is the input, 1 is the output. So either low or high was filtered. So this is outline of this today's session. First we will have recap of the previous class, then introduction to signal, later noises and the types, then filters, analog and digital filters, after the filters activity, after the activity steps to form digital filter. Then filter selection 2:1 multiplexer using transmission gate, end up with summary and evaluation. So today we are going to discuss about filter selection using multiplexer. Before that, recap session. So anyone constraint?
So we have seen about communication, how it took place in the past decades. So communication is by sending information through messengers and also through words. The communication took place in the past years, but nowadays we are using signals, and after birth they also used telegraphs, only messages on which is sent to the receiver, and telephone, where signals are transmitted from one place to another, and later on data, then voice, multimedia communication are being taking place. Thank you.
Yeah, very good. Then along is there here, see the picture. What is it? Yes.
Traffic signal.
Traffic is a correct. So this is a signal. So signal forms is very important in world or communication. So the signal can be defined as any physical quantity that varies with time or any other independent variable. For example, voltage varies with time, as well as continuously monitoring the weather without gap in time. So that is signal. So this signal can be classified into two types, analog signal and digital signal. So the analog signal is also called continuous time signal. So each and so in exercise, this signal in exercises time period, y axis amplitude. So each and every time the value has a little different. So this is continuous time signal. So digital signals consist of zeros and ones, that is digital signal. So any two volunteers come straight. Pick the door. So just shaking the door slowly. What do you feel?
Number of waves produces less.
Number of waves means?
Number of waves per cycle.
Number of waves per cycle. Okay, so 1 or 2 waves is produced. Okay, then if more energy is given, okay, so the number of waves is produced. So if less energy is given, 1 or 2 waves is produced, that is low frequency signal. If more energy is given, the number of waves is produced, that is high frequency signal. So in communication, low frequency and high frequency, these two signals are used. So the low frequency signal is also called SA signal, the high frequency signal is called carrier signal. Okay, what is this?
Noise.
Noises.
Noises. What is noise?
Unwanted signal.
Unwanted signal. Okay, any two more of these comes right? Okay, super. The two persons talking seriously about something. The third, I am third person. I am interfering with your conversation. What do you feel?
Disturb.
Disturb. So that disturb is also called noises. So noises is an unwanted signal. Is an abrupt signal. A lot of noises is introduced in communication. So a lot of noises are short noise, thermal noise, partition noise, and white noise. So thermal noise means which is due to arises in all electronic devices, which is due to random motion of electrons or holes in the conducting material. It is caused by temperature or heat. For example, I am talking with my mobile phone more than 30 or 50 minutes, automatically my mobile phone is heated. So the noise voltage is introduced. Thus, noise voltage is called thermal noise. Then partition noise. Partition noise is arises in all electronic devices. Whenever the current is get divided into two or more parts, the random fluctuations is introduced in the division. So that is called partition noise. For example, the students are assembled in a single line. Suddenly the students separated into two groups or two lines. At that point, the partition noise is introduced. The next type of noise is short noise. The short noise is due to short effect. It is produced in amplifying devices in rather than in all. It is produced in random variations in electrons or holes. So it was shorting the electrical component because of that random motion. So that is called short noise. Then white noise contains all frequency component in equal amount. That is called white noise. A lot of noises introduced in applications, radar, sonar, image transmission, analog and digital signal transmission. So radar means radiation reduction and ranging. So the radar signal using radio waves, it is used to detect the location and distance of an object from the point where radar is placed. So it is working by radiating energy into a space and monitoring the echo or reflected signal from the object. The reflected signal declines rapidly, the distance is increases. So the noise is producing or introducing a certain range of limitation. Then next is sonar. Sonar is sound navigation and ranging. So it uses sound waves to map and locate the object in the surrounding environment. So especially underwater. So first emitter a cluster of sound waves to the direction of the object, while a few waves will bounce off it. The remaining waves reflect back into the direction of the emitter. So that made a noise. The next one is image transmission. The noise is introduced the image at the time of transmission. Insufficient light levels and sensor temperature is introducing the noises in images. For example, X-ray and ECG. Insufficient light level means the image is not clear. So the noise is introduced. Then analog and digital transmission. So in analog transmission, the signal, the noise is added to the signal. So the signal strength is weaker. In digital signal transmission, the analog is converted into series of voltage pulses. The voltage pulses are on same amplitude. For example, 5 volt signal means any interference is occur, the voltage level is bubble, above or below the 5 volts level. So a lot of noises is introduced during the transmission. The signal is affected by the noises. This is main problem in communication. Then the signal transmitting a longer distance, the signal strength is weakened after some distance because the losses of the signal. So a number of signals transmitted through a single channel at a time, the propagation delay is occurred. So these are the main problems in communication.
Okay, as previous professor said, there are a lot of problems in communication, like unwanted things getting added up to the signal, that is the noise. And similarly, we have propagation delay. And so many problems are existing which we have seen in the previous. But today's session we are going to deal with only one particular problem, that is we are going to remove the unwanted things. So can you anyone guess how we are going to remove the unwanted things? Generally, in normal day-to-day life, how we are removing the unwanted things? Can anyone guess? Or else? Okay, based on this, can you tell me what it is?
Coffee filter.
Yeah, what is the purpose of this? It will filter out only, filter out the waste parts. Only the liquid will be going inside, right? So it removes the waste. Similarly, we have lot of filters available in day-to-day life. And in electronics also, we have filters which is used to remove unwanted things. So here is a filter, there are different types of filters. So based on the frequency response, the types of filters are shown here. And here, the various types of filters are low pass, high pass, band pass and band reject. The low pass filter passes only low frequency. We can see how, like x axis is frequency, y axis denotes magnitude. Whenever the magnitude is high, then that particular frequency will be passed. For example, for low pass, from 0 to cutoff frequency fc, we have magnitude high. Only that particular frequency will be passed. For high pass case, frequency from fc and above that will be passed, which is shown by shaded lines. And next is band pass, which will be passing only frequencies between f1 and fh, that is between a low frequency and a high frequency, not very low, between two bands of frequency. And band reject will be doing the opposite of band pass. It will reject the frequencies of between f1 to fh and remaining it will be passing. Okay, let us break for an activity. Can you tell me the middle name of Saurabh Ganguly? Can you guess from the given choices?
Mohandas.
No.
Chandadas.
No. It's Chandidas is the middle name of Saurabh Ganguly. So that we can call as Saurabh Chandidas Ganguly. Can you tell me his present position now? So he is the BCCI chief now. Okay. Next is the Yellowstone National Park is in
France.
No. Others.
USA.
Yeah, exactly correct. Have you all gone through there? Went. Next, can you anyone identify the logo given here? The name of the company associated with the logo.
The second logo, Dell.
Yes.
Fourth one is Nestle.
Yes, good.
Then
some other guess.
Sixth one is Pizza Hut.
Very good.
And ninth one is Coca-Cola.
Yes. Since cola is seen, you are learning that, okay. Good guess. Then, anything else?
No.
Can you check? Okay, these are the answers for the given logos. That is Land Rover, Dell, and Royal Bank of Scotland, the third one, and Nestle, and fifth one is Porsche, the car company, and Pizza Hut. And the seventh one is CNN, and Federal Express is 8th, and Coca-Cola is the 9th, as you said. Okay, so what this signifies is, from this logo is Pizza Hut. If you see that, a hut, inside we have pizza written. This shows that we will be tempted to get, want to buy the pizza and to eat it. So similarly, Nestle. Nestle denotes, a nest is there, and a lot of birds sitting inside that. It actually nurtures the birds inside the nest. So we believe in that and we started buying that product. Okay, coming to the session. Okay, let's continue the session. So as I told you, there are different types of filters. We are going to see the main filters which we'll be continuing. That is the low pass and the high pass. Okay, so low pass filter, as the name says, it passes only low frequency
As in the first session explained by the professor, low pass will have only minimum number of waves, but high pass will have more number of waves per second. Okay. So next is the analog low pass filter, which is consisting of the analog components, resistors and capacitor. These are all passive components which are used in the circuit in order to pass only low frequency signal in the output. Okay. Right. So here the capacitor will be passing only higher frequency. Right. Resistor is used to resist the current flow in the circuit in order to avoid damages. So when you are giving input signal frequency, it can be high or low, but high frequencies will be passed through the capacitor because capacitor will block the low frequency. So higher frequency, when it is passed through the capacitor, it will be grounded. Okay, since it is the capacitor is connected to the ground, all the high frequencies will be grounded and low frequency will be passed to the output. So this will act as a low pass filter. So based on the previous thing, can you explain the high pass filter?
The high pass filter only passing the high frequency signal.
That is more number of
high frequency means more number of waves.
Okay. So it passes only high frequency. Then the circuit, how the circuit operates in passing only high frequency? Can anyone?
RC, both RC, resistor and capacitors in series condition.
Okay.
So it passes the high pass frequencies.
Okay. The capacitor will pass only high frequency to block the low frequency of the DC component. So in that case, only high frequency will be passed here and will give the high frequency at the output. This will block the low frequency. So it acts as a high pass filter. Okay. So previously what we saw is analog filter. Analog filter will filter the analog signals. Analog signals are all naturally available signals. So whatever we are talking, voice, those are all naturally available. So if you want to filter it directly, we can use analog filter. But there are some disadvantages in analog filter. You cannot implement for everything. Like nowadays we have lot of we are dealing with lot of data which cannot be filtered by using simply analog filter. Okay, because the processing must be very fast. So and also we have to store the information. So for that we are going for digital filter. So why digital filter is? It is programmable. We can program it easily. And it is adaptive in the sense it can change its characteristics based on the situation, and that is we can change it directly, and it is simple to design because it is programming and temperature independent. In case of analog filter, resistors and capacitors, the values will be changing often. Even if you are using transistors, active elements, there will be changes in the based on the temperature. It will be, the values will be varying, but in the case of digital filter, it is not. And PCs. It is implemented in PCs, so it is so fast and we can also store it. And complex processing or handle DCB using digital filter. So let us see, so what is the symbol denotes?
Sony laptop.
That's YO, right? So YO says that we have a signal form that is analog. And that side 10, it denotes digital. So here, for comparison between analog and digital, left side is analog and right side we have digital filter frequency response. Okay, if you see the graph on both sides, what is the difference we can see is, if you see there are three bands are available, pass band, transition band and stop band. Okay, so pass band is, this is for low frequency. That is low pass filter. Okay, pass band, here only low frequency will be passed because its magnitude is more. Okay, transition band, there is reduction in the magnitude in the transition band. In the stop band, it is totally reduced. Okay, actually an ideal filter, it has to stop the signals after a particular cutoff frequency. But this is not possible in the case of low pass filter. Low pass filter, even after some cutoff frequency, there is some transition taking place. The transition is large in the case of analog filter compared to digital. Digital, you can see there is only minute transition after cutoff. Okay, this is a very big difference between analog and digital. So we can get accurate results when we go for digital compared to analog. Okay, so that is why we are going for digital filtering. Next, again seeing the difference between analog filter and digital filter. Analog filter, we'll be giving analog signal as input, we'll get analog signal as output. In digital filter, we have to convert the analog signal to digital using A to D converters. Then, after converting to digital, we'll be giving that to digital filter, and finally what we get is a digital values. If you want our signal back as analog again, then we have to use a D to A converter. That is shown in the next slides. And in analog filter, we'll be using components like resistors, capacitor, transistor, etc. Those are aging components. Like if it is aging, then its values also will be changed. And in digital, we'll be using digital components like flip-flops, AND gates, etc. So which are very fast in its switching. So the operation will be fast. And the last point shows the how we design analog filter. Like the example, previous example we saw, the low pass filter, where we can find the capacitance value based on the cutoff frequency specified. If the frequency is 1 kHz, the cutoff frequency we can find out using the formula 1 by 2 pi f into r. Here we assume the value of r. And in the case of digital, from the frequency response, we have to find out impulse response, those things, okay, in order to design a digital filter. And this is what I told you, if you want to process anything in digital, we have to convert the analog signal into digital by using A to D, then we filter it or process it, then what is the output we get is digital, then after that again we have to convert to analog form. Okay? And these are the specifications, like if for example, if a customer is asking for a filter to implement, for example, 1 kHz frequency cutoff, low pass filter if I need, okay, then in that case, the engineer, he has to see how he have to design based on the cutoff frequency mentioned. The customer will be mentioning the other values, like how much attenuation can be possible. Those things and all the customer will be telling. The engineer, he has to take down all those things. And based on that, he has to design a filter. Okay, so here he has to find from the frequency response, he has to find the impulse response. A lot of problem, there is formulas are associated with that. And then after that, we have to find the transfer function. And from the transfer function, that is transfer function is digital. We have to find the final output y of n. Okay. So the final filter will looks like this. The input is x of n, the output is y of n. That means the input will be a combination of a signal plus noise, but output is it's a filtered signal. Okay? In between the part, we have impulse response h. H of 0, h of 1, etc. These represent the impulse response. That is the characteristics of the filter. Okay? And Z inverse and all delay elements. Can anyone tell me what could be the H of N? Okay, leave off. So here, H of N is, I told you the impulse response. It is nothing but the characteristics of the system based on the input 1. That means if you are given a single task, if anyone is given a single task, how you perform, based on that performance only, you will be given other tasks. Okay? So, H of N defines that how you work for a single task. Okay? It is, they call it as characteristics of the system, the impulse response. Okay? So, here, based on low pass, high pass, the H values will be varying. Okay? So, that is in FIR, finite impulse response filter in digital. And this one is IAR filter. This IAR filter is infinite impulse response filter. Okay. Here again we have the input at one side and output at other side. And this is a feedback filter. So we are taking feedback from the output after delay, and it will be multiplying
with the value of minus A1 and it is added and it will be given back along with the input multiplied and delayed. So this is an IER filter. Okay. So thank you.
Stop panirva.
So thank you. As the previous professors discussed about noises and filters, now we are going to discuss about the filter selection using MUX, right? Transmission gate. So this is a simple outline. First one is basic law. And next, what are the basic law? Means two laws mainly we discussed. We are going to discuss about two laws. First one is Ohm's law and second one is Moore's law. Ohm's law is nothing but B is equal to IR, and the Moore's law is nothing but every 18 months the chip size will be doubled. And next, signal. So how can you compare with the signal? From signal to 2:1 MUX. So signal normally divided into two. One is digital, another one is analog. So digital, normally divide the digital, digit plus AL. Digit is nothing but zeros and ones. AL is nothing but absolute logic. Analog is nothing but there is a continuous time signal. Next, transistor. Transistor means transfer the resistor. So it transfer the resistor like a switch. Next, MOS. So transistor types means one is MOS and another one is bipolar. Next, we are going to use here MOS, metal oxide semiconductor. Furtherly, MOS divided into CMOS. So CMOS is the combination of PMOS and NMOS. And next, transmission gate. So why we are using transmission gate means both combination, parallel combination of PMOS and NMOS. So we are using the transmission gate. So from the transmission gate, we are deriving the 2:1 MUX. Because two filters here we are using for the example. One is LPF, low pass filter, another one is HPF, high pass filter. That's why we are using two input and one output MUX. And next, complementary metal oxide. So how can we design, the complementary metal oxide semiconductor design? And next, pass transistor. Next, transmission gate TG. And last one is 2:1 MUX using TG. Next, Moore's law. Already we discussed Moore's law. For every 18 months, the chip size will be doubled. For example, from 1970s to till now, there is a various tremendous changes occur in the transistors. So first SSI, integration levels are available. First one is SSI. SSI having 10 gates and the MSI having, that is, 1000 gates, and the LSI, large scale integration, that is having 10,000 gates, and VLSI more than 10,000 gates are we are using. Next. So here we just make a comparison between bipolar transistor and the MOS transistor. So first one, bipolar, you can easily remember the bipolar. So can any, can you, anyone guess it, NPN? So how can you differentiate NPN and PNP?
Based on the direction of emitter.
Very good. So based on the direction of emitter. Outside means, that is NPN. In means, towards to in means PNP. So you can say, never points in, that is NPN. Never points in means, that's towards the outward direction. Points in permanently means, points in means towards to in. Okay, so that is called PNP. So you can easily differentiate the NPN and the PNP. Here, how the current is transferred means, based on the base voltage or base current, the current is controlled between collector to emitter. That is the same thing here we are using for FET, that is MOS. MOS, here we are using base and that side we are using gate. And the collector emitter, we are using the source and the drain. So based on the gate voltage, the source and the drain current will be controlled. That is the main concepts of bipolar and MOS transistor. Next, complementary MOS. So in the name itself, it has the reason complementary. Complementary means one is conductor to another one is not conductor. So here, one is, already I told, complementary metal oxide semiconductor means PMOS and NMOS. PMOS means pull up transistor. NMOS means pull down transistor. So pull down means it comes under the diagrams. So it pull down, that is towards to ground. Pull up means towards to VDD, that is power supply. So if the input is given, output is getting. So if anyone is on, NMOS is on means PMOS is off. If PMOS is on means NMOS is off. that is complementary. Next, series and parallel connection. So I will give small introduction. So this one is one transistor, just imagine this one is one transistor and this one is another transistor. So you can get the series connection. Series means any one end is connected, not both end, one end is input and another one is output. For example, this one is the input. So given the input means just given the input. Suppose this end is, this downside transistor is closed means the output will not come. Suppose two end, that is two transistor is connected means the output comes, that is the output. So that is the output. So here the output is coming. And next, if the connection is parallel, so if the two transistors both are parallel means if you are given the input, if any one end is closed means another transistor, using the another transistor the output comes. So that is a series and parallel connection. So in summary I can say, if any one transistor is on in parallel, the output comes. But in series, both the transistor must be enabled. Okay. And next, signal strength. So already I told. So what is VDD? How can you say VDD and the ground in digital? Anyone? So how can you say is digital? How can you say another one is zeros and ones? Using the signal. So if one means, that is VDD, power supply. So if the light is glow, for example if you connect the LED, if the light is glow means that is one. If the light not glow means that is zero. So one and zero. Here we are using digital, that's all. So the signal strength, for example already told, NMOS. So NMOS passed the strong zero because it is connected downwards, that is towards to ground. If PMOS pass strong 1, okay, that is both the complementary. So NMOS pass strong 0 and degrader are weak 1. If PMOS is pass strong 1 and degrader 0. Yes, 0s and 1 means nothing but ground means 0, strong means that is VDD. So VDD is connected means that is 1, ground means that is 0. So based on the connection you can decide 0s and 1s. Next. So this is a conduction component. Based on the PMOS and the NMOS, you can get the NAND gate, for example. Because why we are selecting particularly NAND gate means NAND, NOR, these are all the universal gates. From these gates only we can derive all other gates. That's why I give small example about the NAND gate using CMOS. So here dot NS, we just remember this keyword dot NS. Dot denotes NAND gate. N denotes NMOS, S denotes series. So if you draw a NAND gate means NMOS is series. So here look at the picture, NMOS is series. So you can easily remember, if the bubble comes means there is PMOS, P for bubble. NMOS means without bubble. So if NMOS is series, PMOS is parallel. So you can say using this diagram, if NMOS is series, so series means any one end is connected. Another one is the ground end. This one is the another end. So here NMOS is series means PMOS is parallel. Parallel means two end is connected with each other. So you can get, suppose for example, if you take the two input A and B, these are the two input. So if two inputs are one means output zero. How can you say output zero means, if this one is one means this NMOS is enabled. This one is one means this NMOS is also enabled. So if two gates are enable, you can say, already I told with the example, if two gates are enable in series, that will be grounded. So if it is grounded means the output comes, that is 0. So 1 into 1, that is 1, 1 bar is 0. So the output is 0. Okay, that's why we are selecting dot NS as the NAND gate, for example. Suppose I ask one question, from the NAND gate, how can you generate the NOR gate? If the NAND gate here, it is series means for NOR gate, it is parallel. If it is parallel in NAND gate means for NOR gate, it is series. So both are complement. So from this diagram, you can decide NAND gate and also NOR gate. Next, we just discussed about the pass transistor. Pass transistor is nothing but just pass the transistor level, pass the logic, either 0 or 1. So you can decide either 0s and 1 means, already I told, if NMOS is passes the strong 0. So NMOS is pass strong 0 and PMOS is passes strong 1. That is, NMOS is enable when you are given the input 1. PMOS is enable when you are given the input 0. So already I told, PMOS means just remember the bubble. Bubble means 0. Okay, so that is called the pass transistor, individual transistors. Next, why we go for transmission gate? So transmission gate is nothing but PMOS and NMOS combination in parallel. So already I told, pass transistor produces a degraded output. That's why we go for transmission gate. So the disadvantages of pass transistor overcoming in transmission gate. Because transmission gate passes either 0 or 1 based on our selection. So now this is the transmission gate symbol. That is like a box, and here this bubble denotes, already I told, bubble means PMOS. This one is NMOS. So you can say this bubble means GB, that is G bubble, G bar, and this one is G. And this is also available. So one diode, you can make one diode and the cross connection, that is another diode. So these are all the symbols of transmission gate. Okay. So why we are using this transmission gate means to generate or to design the MUX using this transmission gate. That's why we are using the transmission gate. So multiplexer, why we are using this multiplexer for filter selection means, here the two inputs, that is T0 and D1, these are all the two inputs here we are using. S is the select signal, Y is the output signal. Here, this is the S signal, that is S means 0 or 1. If the S signal 0 means D0 is selected. So in the diagram itself it denotes S, that is S 0 means D0 comes as the output. If S 1 means D1 comes as a output. So this D0, D1 either may be 0s or 1. So that may be decided by S. So here you see the truth table. S is 0. The S is 0 means what is the input? That is, if the input D0 is 0, then output comes 0. Suppose if the input 1, that is S select signal 1 means, that is a select signal. So D1 is selected. D1 is 0 means output comes 0. So based on the select signal, we can select the input as the output. That's why we are using the multiplexer. Next. So why we go for multiplexer? That is the reason. So can anyone say what is the output? That is output here S 0, then D0 is selected. Then what is the output? Here what is the output? That is second row.
1 1.
Very good. So D0 is 1, so the 1 comes as a output. Okay. Suppose if the select signal is 1, then which one is selected?
D1.
D1 is selected. Which so is what zero. Another input it may be, either 0s or 1, D1 is selected as an output. So here, from this previous truth table, we can select this derivation. That is the derivations. Y is equal to SD1 plus S bar D0. So here you can convert this derivation logic equation into this diagram means, that is a D1. Here we are using one AND gate, two AND gates and one inverter. Inverter is given for S bar and that one is R gate. R gate for plus symbol. So you can select this Y. So just to convert the diagram into universal gates, that is CMOS level, you may use this number of transistors. For example, we cannot use directly AND gate. So NAND gate, then inverter connected, then only you can get the AND gate. If NOR gate means R gate, NOR gate and the inverter, then only you can get the R gate. Because from the universal gate only we can design the AND gate or R gate. So that's why, for example, this one is here, not, that is NOT gate. So NOT gate means both the combination of PMOS and NMOS series. So you can use two transistors. So two transistors here, four transistors. So totally, if you add this all transistor count means you can get 20 transistors. So instead of using 20 transistors, we can use only 4 transistors in transmission gate. Okay. So how we decide in next to the slide. So here this is the transmission gate mux. Here you can get this mux. Already we discussed the mux diagram. What is bubble denotes? Anyone?
PMOS.
Very good. So bubble means PMOS. So here the bubble comes under the diagram. And you may say D0, D1, and this one is the S bar, and this one is the S and S. So here you can say, if S is equal to 1, which gate is enabled? Transmission gate 1, this one is transmission gate is 2. So if S is equal to 1, which one is enabled?
D1.
So D1 is enabled, because this one is the S. S is equal to 1 means this one is NMOS, and this one is PMOS, this one is not enabled. So D1 comes as out. If S is equal to 0 means which one is enabled?
D0.
This D0. Because bubble. So S is equal to 0 means D0 comes as out. Here, why we are using this MUX for filter selection means the filter output, that is low pass filter output, is given as D0. D0 is nothing but low pass filter output. D1 is nothing but high pass filter output. So based on this, we can select either we may use low pass filter or high pass filter. So based on the application, we can select the filter. That's why we are using the MUX. Okay. Next. So this is already told, the filter's output. So here the filter's output given as an input of the MUX. So based on the select signal, we can use the filters. If the select signal, because two types of select signal we are using, either zeros or ones. If zero means the low pass filter is selected. If 1 means high pass filter is selected. Next.
We will summarize today's topic. Filter selection using MUX is our title. Then in that we have seen this noise signal. Signal is nothing but you want to transmit the signal from one end to another end. Then how a number of noises will be affected during environmental. That type we will discuss about more types of noise. That we are choosing one of the filter. There are filters are classified into two types, analog and digital. In our topic we will be choosing the digital because of accuracy. In digital they have classified into two types, low pass filter and high pass filter. In the uses of 2:1 multiplexer. In 2:12 multiplexer we have used the combination of P and N MUX transmission gates. Once we are choosing the transmission gate, PMOS means 0 will be enabled to PMOS will be automatically display the output. 1 means high pass filter will be enabled. Similar to 0 means low pass filter will be enabled in the transmission gates.
So thank you. So we can go for some evaluation technique. First one is, can anyone say list the type of noise?
Short noise, thermal noise.
Types of noises are short noise, thermal noise, body shear noise, white noise, etc.
Very good. Next, in parallel connection of CMOS transistor, either one transistor is on. So already I told with the example, if parallel connection, anyone end is on. If parallel, these are all the parallel. Parallel means already I told, two end is connected with each other. So if anyone end is on, then what is output?
On.
Just imagine.
Then the output is on.
The output is on or enable. Very good. Next, how can you differentiate? Differentiate LPF and HPF.
LPF causes only low frequency signal. The HPF causes only high frequency signal. This is the main difference between low pass filter and high pass filter.
And also combination of resistor and capacitor. Yes. How it is connected, we can form low pass and high pass filter.
Yes, very good. Next, identify the applications of multiplexer. So last portion we discussed about multiplexer. What are the ID? That is, identify the applications.
Multiplexer.
Washing machine.
How can I say washing machine?
Too many options are
available. We may select based on our input. Okay. very good. Maybe accepted.
Telephone signals.
Telephone signals, very good. Suppose if you are sending, if you are calling many people, suppose a receiver is available, if you are calling many people means the channel, which channel is enabled, based on the channel enabled, the call is received. Very good. Next. Outline the advantages of transmission kit. Why we are using transmission kit?
Reducing the transistor count.
Very good. Reducing the transistor count. Very good. So that is the main advantages. And another one advantages is transmission gate. You can transmit the signal either zeros or ones. So based on our convenient, you can transfer the, either the signal zeros or ones. That is the main advantages. Next. So next, how many transistors are needed? So previous session we discussed how many transistors are needed. Y is equal to SE1. That is MUX logic derivations.
20.
20 transistors. Very good. Next, we can go for a simple crossword section. So students, you may select the questions, and from the questions you can make the crossword. And can you display? So I will give some more minutes, and you make the questions. From this session you can make the questions, and from this question you can generate the crossword. So take your time, 2 minutes you can take the time. So this session is useful for self-evaluation. That's why I told this crossword puzzles. So can anyone come and say the questions with the crossword?
For example, across which forms main part of communication? So the answer is signal. In the crossword, in across, for one, we have given a signal. And next is unwanted disturbances added to communication is that it is given in down. So for two, it is down. So unwanted signal is noise. So it is written as noise.
Okay, thank you.